Split function. There's two different ways of using split function. One is by using it as a function with formula, and another way is by using the data cleanup option in the top menu, and I'll show you how to split text to column. That's the option, the same as split function. But let's just use the formula first. I have employee names, and I have a mixture of first name, last name, and sometimes first name, middle initial, and a last name. And I wanna separate into first, middle, and last. So you just start typing the formula, split, then you specify the text. Then you have to give the formula what kind of delimiter you want to use for the split function. I want to use space and close parenthesis and enter. And then you can just drag this down and it will copy down. Now you can see that it's doing okay job, but it still has, you know, in some cases we have the name spread over three columns. In other cases we have over two. It depends if there's a middle name or not. So you would have to copy this as volume, because right now this is as a formula, and then maybe move it manually some of these less names over one column. And I'm going to give you another example where you can see this better how this works, and we will go over the couple of other options that the formula has. So right now we just use the two options in the formula. So the formula is like, I have this average home prices information here, but you can see that the data, it's all in one cell, and I would want to separate into different months and then the amounts of average price for different region. And I have these different delimiters in between some of the data points. So I have a percent, at sign, and then percentage sign. And I want to show you how this works with the two other options available in the formula. So the first one, we're just going to use exactly how we did it before. We're going to say split, and then we're going to select this, the text. And now here, I'm going to actually specify the three different delimiters, or actually four, that I have in this text. So I'm going to have a space, ampersand, and then at sign, and then percentage sign, close the quotation mark. Then, by default, the third option is split by each, meaning, do you want to split by each delimiter? So if there's multiple, you want to treat them all individually, or are they all as one? And so I'm going to say true. They should be used separately. And the last option is, do you want to remove any empty text if there's multiple delimiters? So I'm going to say true. And in this case, I'm going to copy this over to the two examples with the average prices as well as the month name. So you can see here that it treated the delimiter between the name, which is November 2021, there's an ampersand. It separated these dates for me. Then it's also separated when I see at sign and percentages and a space. So I have it kind of month and a year separated. Here in this case, we just have ampersand and percentage sign. So it's just put the prices in different columns. So now let's see what happens if we change this. And let's, for the second statement, split by each, we're still going to say yes, play by each, but now we're going to eat space in between multiple delimiters. So in this case, you can see that it starts the same as in previous case, but then it starts adding spaces, because then we have the at sign and percentage delimiter here. So it's adding one space for multiple delimiters. So you see how the data just, it's more spread out. And let's say with the numbers, it's the same thing, because we have at sign and percentage, and it's saying, okay, so now you want to have an empty space in between multiple delimiters. Now let's see how this will look if we change and say treat the multiple delimiters as one and don't add any empty space. So in this case, this really didn't work well because there is no case where we have all three delimiters together. We have at and percentage sign together, but we don't have, you know, ampersand, space, at sign and percentage sign together. So that's why it's copied over into one cell. So it didn't really do anything really for us because there was no case to be found. And it's going to be the same case if we do the third and fourth option is false, false, because again, we can't find it in these situations. So in this case, if I want to still clean this up, maybe the option would be to actually not use the first delimiter as the ampersand. I would just remove it. So then I have the month separated and, you know, it looks much nicer. So sometimes you might have to actually maybe do twice the formula to split it as you would like. And let me remove it from this case. And let me remove it from this case. So now you'll be able to find it that, because there were before there was no case of having all the delimiters together. And let's see what happens in the last case when we remove it. The same. So sometimes you might have to play around with, you know, what delimiters you're using and some of the options, the third and fourth options, if you want to treat them all the delimiters together or separately. And then let's go back to the employees area right here. And I want to show you the other way to use the split function. It's actually not using it as function, but using it as a option on the menu. So if you have this data right here, you can just select it. And now you can go to data, split text to column. And it will ask you the same question. What kind of delimiter do you want to use? You can just say automatically, or you can say specify custom or the ones that are by default, comma, semicolon, period, space. I'm going to say space and it separated quickly for me. However, be aware that the original data is over, it's copied over, so you no longer have the original data with the function. You still have the original data and then you have the function and the data in the next column. So be aware that you're copying over the original data. So that's the way to use split function and option in Google Sheets. Thanks so much for watching.